Phillips from Life Survival down in Central Florida. I'm up here in Gainesville today. I've teamed up with Survival Dispatch, and we're going over some of our favorite gear and favorite products. And one of the pieces that I have here recently that I can't not mention is the Keen Newport H2. Now, Keen's kindly given me these shoes to test. I explained to them the problem that I have with my last three pair of Teva sandals. I've been through Chacos. I've been through a bunch of different sandals. What happens here in Florida as a local guide, an outdoorsman, a survivalist, a bushcrafter, let's say, I spend a lot of time in and around and near water. I'm in and out of the swamp, I'm in and out of the springs, the rivers, salt water, I'm fishing in the flats, fishing in the surf, paddleboarding, all kinds of stuff. And to add to all that exposure, the heat here in Florida. You can cook an egg on the sidewalk in Florida, no problem, guys. This is the Keen Newport H2, a phenomenal shoe. The toe guard on the front has saved my toes countless times, guys, in the river. You bring your foot down, I can feel the toe guard moving across a rock. That would have ripped off a toenail, and it has happened in the past. The sewing, the stitching is solid. It's on point, it's straight. They're using heavy, almost like a heavy weighted thread, and it has an interesting stitch pattern. It actually, it's tough to get on the camera there, but if you can look closely, the stitch pattern actually alternates back and forth. So it covers a wider band and provides for a more secure attachment from material to material. One of the big problems I run into often with these type of shoes, and this is the type of shoe that I have to wear. Flip-flops aren't gonna stay on my feet. This is something that I can strap to my feet and keep on my feet. One of the biggest problems I run into is separation in the sole. You've got two pieces that are usually glued and pressed together, and you can already, from the factory, a lot of times you can already see a glue line, and what happens is that gets wet, it dries out. It gets wet with salt water, it dries out. Or it gets wet, it stays in my Jeep for a week, and it's still wet when it comes out a week later because it's incredibly hot out and it's really high humidity here where we live. So I am 10 weeks into testing these shoes. They've held up exceptionally well, no separation at all, no threads coming out anywhere. The bungees and the straps are still have a lot of elasticity to them. That's something that I've run into, a problem I've run into in the past, is the elasticity goes very quickly. As you know, with most rubber and those type of like rubber bands, for instance, you get it wet and dry it out a couple times, you start to see the cracks, it doesn't have the same elasticity anymore, and you lose that. In this situation, this stretches out, my tying cord stretches out, and I've got this like huge length flopping around on the side of my shoe, and then I've got to adjust it myself. So far, not been a problem, and I've worn the crap out of these things. The only drawback, and it's killing me right now, folks, I know I'm not showing it, but it's killing me right now, is they stink horribly. I don't have stinky feet. I've never had stinky feet. I wear flip-flops, sandals. Like I said, I've got three pair of Tevas at home. I've got Chacos, I've got tennis shoes, all kinds of shoes that I wear, and they don't stink. Now, what does happen from time to time is because my feet are exposed so often, the skin gets really dry, especially around my heel, and because I'm in and out of the water so much, my feet will actually stay wet and retain moisture, and I will grow algae and mold on my feet. I know that's disgusting. It's the price I pay for doing what I love doing. Back to the stink. These smell rancid. Inside of them, there is an anti-odor anatomic footbed. Right here, anti-odor anatomic footbed. I have no idea what that means, but I'm assuming it means anti-odor does not stink. That is a lie. I'll let you know here in the next 2 or 3 months, come back and finish my gear test on these Keen Newport H2s and let you know how everything else turned out. In the meantime, I'm gonna fight the odor here and I'll have to quit blaming my 5-year-old son. I swear I thought it was his feet and not mine. But I'll keep you guys posted. So far, these have been incredible shoes aside from the odor factor. So. Thanks, guys. Thanks for tuning in. These are Keen Newport H2s. I'm beating the crap out of this pair right now. Good results so far. Stay posted. Keep watching, and I'll let you know here in the next couple of months how my gear test turned out.